Hello everyone, this is Sowardo Pal and today we'll be designing rectangular waveguide WR90 using HFSS. As you can see on the screen, here are the dimensions that we'll be using for the designing purpose. So first we will head over to this file, then new, then the new project will appear over here. Then we are going to save the project by our project name. You can name it anything. I am naming it WR90 waveguide. After creation, click over this insert HFSS design over here. I'm going to click this. The 3D Cartesian system will appear and we can start designing on this plane accordingly. Let's bring this thing to the center first and adjust accordingly before designing. We will be designing the the rectangular waveguide along the Z direction. So we are going to set accordingly. One second. Then after setting it correctly, then we are going to draw a box. Accordingly, you can see we are going to xy direction and extend along the z direction, negative z direction. The material will be copper in our case, so we can change this thing accordingly. You can see copper have appeared over here. We are going to use that thing. Copper. Then we're going to click OK. Then we are going to set the dimensions of the box as we have drawn the box arbitrarily of in the first case. So starting position should be 000 for the box and the x dimension or the. The width of this waveguide will be 0.9 inches. So we are going to say name it width as a variable and it is going to ask for the values and I'm going to set it as inch and the value should be 0.9 inches. As you can see on the screen, the value is there. The height should be around 0.4 inches, so we are going to name a variable height and give it a value of 0.4 inches. These are the values that are in standard of WR90 and you can search it anywhere in the internet for the exact dimensions. And the length that we are going to use length to be as 20 centimeter and it has to be towards a negative length because we have extruded the structure towards the negative direction of Z and we are going to give it 20 centimeter is 20 centimeter. This is actually the inner structure the part. The inner dimensions. Then I'm going to click OK. After that, a new object has been created. You can see over here, the object is very long. You can change the things accordingly. First of all, then this is the inner dimension part. Then we need to create the outer dimension so that we can create. The shape accordingly. As you can see in the first case, there should be a hollow structure and not just a solid structure of copper. then we are going to copy this box, and in the box 2 we are going to change the dimensions accordingly, the x and the height, the width should be plus 2 times of thickness, 2 star thick, thickness should be of around 1 millimeter, so 1 mm. The height should also be 2 times, as you can see the thickness. Okay, the length will remain same for both the cases, and its starting position will change because it will be a little bit off center, so it will be from minus x and y thick to, and y is also going to minus thick. Z position should be the same, as you can think so. And so here, if I am going to zoom over here, there you can see there are 2 boxes. The box 1 is this one, the inner part, and the box 2 is the outer part, and we need the hollow section in between this. So for that, what we are going to do is first select the outer box, then pressing shift we are going to select the box 1, then after that we are going to select the subtract over here. This is the symbol of subtract, we are going to select that. So I'm going to select that. After that, we ask for the blank part and the tool part. So this is set accordingly, and we can click OK now. And so as you will not see any difference right now, but I can show you the difference. What happened is that it the structure has become hollow, as you can see. And if you see the actual diagram, the structure is similar to this that we have right now. So we have little bit of structure. Then what we can do is, this is the actual structure, right? So just a second, we can change the color to little bit this color for better visibility. 0.8 would be great, I think. Yes, you can see the structure of this thing. So after this, we are going to need to draw the radiation box. Radiation box is the actual boundary beyond inside which the calculations are being done, and we need to keep the radiation box as small as possible so that we can compute the results very fast. So the box, the radiation box will be similar to this one. So we are going to copy this and paste this over here, and in the material part we are going to choose vacuum, and visibility to be around 0.9 would be great, or 0.95 would be better. Okay, so this box is vacuum, and its dimensions need to be a little bit more than the waveguide. So for that, what you are going to do, just a second, for that what we're going to do is that for box 3 we need to change the dimensions. So this time the thickness, the height, the height and the width of the box should be more than the actual waveguide. So I am going to set this as 4 times. It will be better, I think. 4 times of this, the length should be the same, I guess. Length, actually, you can do so by actually increasing the thing. 2 times thick. Just use brackets for the same thing. And the position, starting position should be minus of 2 times thickness, and minus of 2 times thickness, that is minus thickness, and these are the x and x, y and z positions respectively. As you can see, if I zoom over here, the actual structure is the copper part is this box, which is hollow, and the radiation box is this part, which is a little bit bigger than the actual structure. You can see this thing from every aspect. I can show you that this thing. Okay, there is some problem with this. Okay, let me fix that. Don't need the subtract part because the radiation box need to be solid. Okay. Thickness and thickness. Okay. So 2 times thickness minus length. Oh, so this should be the plus. This should be the not be negative. This should be the plus. Okay, then you can see the radiation box is a little bit extruded than the actual structure, and this is the actual what we need for this case. The structure should be confined within the radiation box, or else the calculations will be done properly. Okay, so these are the things that we have designed. And if we check on here what we need. We need 3D model boundaries and analysis setup. So for that, we will head over to this section, the boundaries. So this structure should be shared as boundaries in this case. For that, we will go to this assign boundary radiation. So we click on OK. So after setting the boundary, you can see the structure has some patterns in it, which tells that it is a set as radiation boundary. And for that, we are now need to set the port, excitation ports. So for that, what you're going to do is choose the sheets. Accordingly, the sheets should be there for setting the port. This is the dimensions of this, I guess. So these are the dimensions of the sheet that we are going to use for the port or excitation port part. The position should be 000, the axis should be Z, X should be the width, and this should be the height. Same as the waveguide structure. So this is the structure that has been created. We are going to copy this thing and paste it for this other end of the waveguide. And for that, we are going to use position size Z. So Z should be this time minus length. And as you can see, the structure has been created on both the sides, and this will be used as a port for the field excitation. So we are going to use this port as the first excitation, and so we are going to use this as apply assign excitation, and this should be a wave port. Wave port. We can click on next. Integration line, you can use integration line is how you set it from this part to this part. And click on next. Do not change these things and just click finish, and you can see that the waveport have been created, and there is the arrow of the excitation, which tells in which direction the waves has been excited in this port. And this will be the lumped port, because here we will be able to vary the impedance according to our need. So what we're going to do is click on unassign sheets and click on assign excitation. This should be lump mode, as I said. We will be able to vary the impedance accordingly. So for now, I am going to use random values. When later on the design result section, we will be able to visualize the change of the impedance and other characteristic according to these impedances. So we're going to use the integration line, same as the other one. We're going to use that, and click on next. You can set do not renormalize, finish. Like, as you can see, the structure have been created properly, and the excitation part is also done. And when you click over this, you can see the analysis setup and 3D model section is just remaining. For analysis, we are going to set add solution setup, and in this tab, what we need to do is give the frequencies for which primarily the solutions will be calculated. I am going to choose 10 GHz as of now, because WR90 ranges from 7 GHz to around 13 GHz, and I am going to check for the 10 GHz as of now, and don't change anything other than this. For viewing the results, like for different frequencies, we can add a frequency sweep. For adding frequency sweep, what you can do is, as you said, primarily frequency will be 10 GHz, so you can start from 5 till 15 for the frequency sweep, and step size should be 0.1, and this should be fast. Okay, so the solution setup has been done, and you can see we have added the frequencies and the parameters that we need. And what we need to do is 3D model. Just a second. So for this error, as you can see, the 3D model, we have some missing link. Like this box 4 is not assigned. I don't know where from where it came. Maybe some error. So we are going to delete this part, and I'm going to check this. As you can see, all the parameters have been successfully been added. The design is complete. The next step would be the analysis part, and this will be covered in the next part of the video. And for this, as of now, the designing part is complete, and you can just file and save the file accordingly. And later I will show you how to view the results of the different parameters varying over the frequencies and impedances and many other things. So this is as for now, and we have successfully designed the parameters which are given in this slide, as you can see, and the design part is already complete. And thank you for this.